In this illustration, we'll analyze a situation when internal reflection takes place inside a bent rod. Here the figure shows a rod of diameter D, which is bent in shape of an arc of inner radius R, as we can see here, and shown refractive index of its material is 3/2, and we are able to find the maximum value of D by R for which all light rays entering normally at face A of rod will come out only from end B. So, in this situation here we can see, I can redraw the picture of this bent rod, and here if the light ray is entering at end A and it has to come out only from end B, that means that every interior point wherever light ray will incident must be internally reflected. So, all light rays which are getting into an A, when they will incident on the curved surface of this outer part of the bent rod, it must be internally reflected. And from this point here, we can see this ray which is coming at the inner surface or grazing along the edge of the inner surface of this rod will be incident at the least angle of incidence, because for all other rays entering into A, the angle of incidence with respect to the normal will be more than this. So, if this angle theta C is greater than critical angle, it will be internally reflected. Then, at all points wherever this will go due to the curved surface of same radius of curvature, the angle would be equal. So, it will be internally reflected and finally light will come out only from end B only. So, here we can say for total internal reflection to take place, for all light rays entering at A, we use theta should be greater than or equal to critical angle. Here, we know that critical angle can be written as sin inverse 1 by mu. So, here we can write the value of sin theta should be equals to, we are using equality as a limiting case. This should be 1 by mu, and in this triangle we can see if this angle is R, this length will be R plus D. So, in this situation the value of sin theta will be R by R plus D. And if we substitute the value of mu, which is given as 3/2, here we can see it is R by R plus D is equals to 2/3. And it is 3R is equals to 2R plus 2D, which gives 2D is equals to R, and the value of D by R we are getting is 1/2. So, this is the maximum value of D by R. If the value of D by R increases beyond this, the value of angle theta will be less than critical angle and light will be refracted out from the curved surface. So, this is the maximum value of D by R, and this is the final result of this problem.